Hello, this video is going to examine a nonparametric test called the Runs test. So first, let's define what a run is. And it's a sequence of data where the characteristic is the same, and it's bookended by data with a different characteristic. So for example, if we're looking at the birth gender for babies, we will maybe notice a run of females here, or males. There's a run of two males here, a run of two females there. So there are a total of 8 runs in this sequence, and those are the lengths. The length of the run is the number of times that it repeats. So what the runs test can tell us is whether or not a particular sequence is random. Okay, so we want to know if it's a random sequence or if there's something maybe causing this the sequence to occur. So the test statistic, when the sample size 1 is less than 20 or equal to it, and also the sample size 2 is less than or equal to 20, the test statistic is G, which is going to be the number of runs. When N1 or N2 is greater than 20, the test statistic is going to be Z equal to G minus the mean runs over the standard deviation of runs. And we can calculate those down here, where the mean of runs is 2 times the sample size product divided by the sum of sample sizes plus 1. And the standard deviation is going to be the square root of, in the numerator, 2 times the product of the sample sizes times 2 times the product of the sample sizes minus sample 1 minus sample 2. All of that is divided by the product of n1 plus n2 squared times n1 plus n2 minus 1. And these are the steps for the runs test. First, we identify the claim in terms of our null and alternative hypothesis. We specify our level of significance, our alpha. We determine the number of data that have each characteristic and the number of runs. So that will give us N1, N2, and G. Then we determine our critical value, which is going to be based first on the size of our samples. And using our table, we find our critical value. And then we calculate our test statistic based on the size of our samples. Based on the outcome of that, we compare our test statistic to our critical value and make our decision whether or not to reject the null. We then interpret the decision in the context of the original claim. Here's an example of the runs test. We have an English professor at a college. It's usually late for class. Students decide to record whether he's late or on time, so L or T. The results are below, so at the 0.05 level, we want to know if we can conclude that the sequence is not random. So the null is that the sequence of arrival is random. So the lateness is just a random sort of thing. Or the alternative is that there's something going on here causing the lateness. So the N1, the number of on times, is going to be 42. And N2, the number of being late, is 16. And G, the number of runs, is 32. So based on our N1 sample being greater than 20, we use table 4 to find the critical values of Z, our Z table. And at the negative side of that, it's -1.96, and on the positive side, it's 1.96. So the test statistic, based on that, we have to find our mean of runs, which comes out to 24.1724. And our standard deviation of runs, 3.002. Using that information, we calculate our test statistic Z, which comes out to 2.61. That does fall outside of our confidence interval between 1.96 and -1.96. So at the 5% level, there is enough evidence to support the claim that the sequence of arrival is not random. Here's another example. The same professor has an afternoon class, and the students there also record lateness or being on time. And here is the data from that. So the null we're going to be testing is whether the sequence of arrival is random again. And the alternative is that they're not random. So n1 is the number of on times. In this case, it's 9. For sample 2, the number of lates is going to be 20. And the sequence number of runs is 12. So continuing our example, based on n1 being less than or equal to 20, and n2 also being less than or equal to 20, we're going to use table 12 to find the lower critical value 8 and the upper value 18. Our test statistic is the number of runs, so that's 12. Because 12 is between the critical value of 8 and 18, we fail to reject the null this time. So at the 5% level, there is not enough evidence to support the claim that the sequence of arrival is not random.